Thank you very much for giving me opportunity to present. The presentation I would like to present is swine data and swine map, Myanmar swine data and swine map. My department is the Land Use Division, Department of Agriculture. That the Department of Agriculture is same ministry of the first presenter, same ministry, and but the different departments. I'm working under the Department of Agriculture Land Use Division. The aim of our Land Use Division is to build up swine map, swine fertility map, and crop suitability map. Mainly in our department, we can have soil data. And the objective of our department is mainly on swine classification, swine and water analysis, and also recommend on cropping based upon swine types, cropping system based on the swine types or different agroecological zones, and also recommending the fertilizer management and also the irrigation frequency. And after that, we also made different kinds of properties, meteorological conditions. Based on that kinds of data, we recommend how to manage the fertilizers and how to grow the cropping management systems. And also we do the swine water and fertilizer analysis, and also swine survey and mapping, and also giving training and education. It's when we do the training and education most on the soil and water management. And swine survey and mapping is, we are currently work, but not for, not cover the whole country. Let's see our history of swine classification. And this is actually the swine classification we have to mention. We are very thanks to the Russia, because the history is the very important, the help of the Russia, Soviet Russia Federation. Let's see, in 1955 to 57, Agricultural Planning Commission made a classification mainly based on the data of aerial photo interpretation. 1957, we did general scientific classification with the help of Soviet swine expert, mainly based on the Russian system. The map you can see in, later I will show the swine map, you can see the swine, different swine type, is actually based on the Russian system. In 1970, the old classification system was modified by Land Use Division, Myanmar Agriculture Service. Before our department is called Department Myanmar Agriculture Service, now we call the Department of Agriculture, same department, to correlate with the FAO UNESCO classification. This is the our swine type maps. Is dominant swine type is 11. But when the 11, mainly the dominant swine type is 11 swine type, but when we classify actually 24 swine types in Myanmar, because only this is the only dominant swine type. And we have different state and region. We have the swine map. Swine map of the different state and region. We have 14 different state and region map, and now we already built the Nibiru. This one, the one you are here, is already coming up the swine map. But I only show the old swine map of 14 state and region. This is the Kenyan state, where you can see 5 swine types, and also the map of Chin state, you can see 3 swine types in Chin state. This is the northern part of Myanmar, this Chin state. And another one is the Sakai region. Sakai region is the middle part of our country. You can see 11 swine types of swine types. And the Tanindai region, this is the lowest part of Myanmar, the southern part of Myanmar near Thailand. And this is the 8 kinds of swine type you can see here. Also, this is the Bakau region and Makwe region. You can see 9 swine types in Bakau region, 10 swine types in Makwe region. And another one, you can see the Mandalay region and Mon state. That this is the dry zone of Myanmar. You can see 11 swine types, and Mon state, you can see 8 swine types in Myanmar. And this is the Rakai, the coastal part of the northern part or the western part of Myanmar, the coastal area. This is five kinds of swine types. And this is the Yangon region. The one you will visit that region, that is, you can find in eight kinds of swine types. And this is the Shanstai and Aori region swine type. You can see that. And that swine types I myself and Ao Chow Tu, we made the data of swine male for that we already computerized. You can, yes. And the ACEL table, we already did. That kinds of data we have. We already, at each and every state and region, we already computerized. You can see the swine depth, texture, pH, fertility status, suitable crop, and amelioration measure. We have that kinds of data now. And Land Use Department also making swine survey. That is the recently work in the our department. This is the, I think you, we made with the Thailand group, I think that is the documentary. Is the leader of swine surveyor, and that kinds of data, we get that data from the inventory, yeah. So this is the one we made in the Sandy watershed area. We have that, this data we have, this the already computerized in database, and also as ACEL format.
ACEL format data.
In this data, we have already georef, we have also GPS point, and also the swine fertility data, swine texture data we have. So we have already GPS point, profile number, swine depth, swine textures, and then all other, and also fertility data we have. And also in our department is implementing integrated high technological demonstration villages. That means that village, all of the farmers are followed by the guideline of the swine and water management, integrated pest management, etc. The crop management to improve the farmers' livelihood. That villages, our extension staff have to collect the soil data and send to the swine analytical laboratory, and then they give the swine analysis results. And also after getting swine analysis results, our land use department made fertilizer recommendation and other management practices. So we have that kinds of data and already computerized. But the only things we point is we don't have any GPS point in that village. That's why I have to also, I will ask later on Dr. Oleg about that kinds of data, what we need to do, we should need to do to combine that kinds of data. We have that kinds of data. This is in our departments, totally we have 281 villages we are implementing, and the sample number is 1,442 data. This is the 2018 fiscal year. So we have already ACEL format in our department. I just only show that kind of data. Also, we have another kinds of data in our department is the experimental site of land use division, as each and every state and region map, region. And also good agricultural practice field, we have mango, strawberry, and also seasonal rice. That way we have swine data in our department, and also the swine data of demonstration block, and also the swine data of problem swine data we have in our department have. And also we have current activities in the Pyobe Township. This is the ACIR project we have. They are making only two townships, the Pyobe and the Bokoku Township. This is one a part of my, I'm working with only 1 week's activities and I work there. But we can have that kinds of data and collaborating with, I think, DAR. And but most of the data are getting in LUD, Land Use Departments. So we have that kinds of, with that kinds of data we have. They just use only, I think, the one is 200,000 scale map, they are doing like this. Site generator software, they use it. And also they use the seed point and transit point. And all, every seed point we have 4 transit points. This is also we use the software, the GPS point when we dig this, we get soil sample. And also we use another soil sampling procedure like the procedure of ACIR. And also we use the concave tablet, we don't use the paper, we only use the, we use this kind of concave. And also new site description and new layer description we have. And also we use fine color charts like the formal fine classification procedure. And also we, but the things we impressed in that project was they have always, after work, after finish of the day, working day, they always uploaded to that data to the web cloud. And also checking the data all every day, they check all the data. So that is a good point for, and we have to learn a lot there. So. But we have many challenges for the data management for information system, but because we need to have the knowledge of the data management system, especially, I think we are behind Thailand because we saw the Thailand Development Department, they already improved, but our department is still learning process, so we need to have that kinds of the capacity building for data management, and also we need to have the georeferencing and educating the that kinds of data. We have many challenges. We need to cooperate and coordinate, and also we would like to, we need to learn a lot from the experts of the soil scientists. That's it all. Thank you very much. Yeah.